A press conference called on Wednesday by Kitui MPs allied to Senator David Musila, convening to issue a warning to party leader Kalonzo Musyoka, whom they accused of meddling in the Wiper gubernatorial race in Kitui. 2 weeks ago, on his voter mobilization tour of Kitui, the former vice president is said to have pleaded with the locals to re-elect incumbent Julius Malombe in the presence of Senator Musila, who is angling for the position. The move by Musyoka sparking off anger from Musila, who is the Wiper chairman, withdrawing from the convoy in protest. But the rift could just be the beginning of what promises to be a bruising battle that could see Musyoka lose some of his loyal allies. In response to the statements by Musila and his team Wednesday, Governor Malombe has accused Senator Musila of blackmailing the former vice president. Addressing supporters at a rally in Mwingi, Malombe accused Musila and the MPs allied to him of being led by greed.
Kwa sababu yeye ndiye national chairman wa Wiper Democratic Party, ati apatiwe direct ticket ya kusimama chio chochote ambao anataka na anataka hiki cha governor wa Kitui. Na akaambiwa haiwezekani wakati huu kupatiwa direct ticket. Na sasa inaonekana haina semekana. Alikuwa ameambia hata wale MPs ambao wako katika viti sasa. Hata kina mtambo ambao wako hapa. Alikuwa amewaambia na amewaahidi atawapatia ticket direct.
Malombe says Musila is not his match and his bid for the gubernatorial seat was to sabotage Musyoka's bid for the presidency.
Tumesikia wengine wanasaidishwa na hata uenda ikawa imemalizika kuandikisha chama kingine ambayo itakuwa na jina ambayo iko karibu na wapi. Na wanataka wakitumiwa ni wale ambao wanawatumia. Wanataka kufika mahali waondoke ili kiongozi wetu Kalonzo Musyoka awezi kubalika kurusha ibendele ya NASA.
But the job of quelling political tensions may not be Kalonzo Musyoka's alone. President Uhuru Kenyatta might find himself in the same spot in Nyandarua after Area Deputy Governor Mwangi Kirika declared intentions to challenge his boss Daniel Waithaka Mwangi. The two are expected to face off in the Jubilee nominations, with Waithaka announcing that he was looking for a new running mate.
Tafuta kazi chana kigine, na ni lazima ni pebereze he, ni ufudiche mambo ya kuendelea na serikali. Kiwa ni mmoja wa wale wasichana mimi natafuta, akijitokeza vizuri, itakuwa ni.
And that's not all for the president, as two political heavyweights, namely Kisii Senator Chris Obure and Area Deputy Governor Josh Maange, go head-to-head for the Jubilee ticket for the Kisii gubernatorial position. The two candidates are likely to complicate matters for the party in Kisii County, largely viewed as owing allegiance to code leader Raila Odinga. Maange has vowed to push to the end, expressing confidence of beating Obure at the nominations.
It would be a mistake for me to have worked this hard to bring Jubilee to Kisii County and then just sit back and let it go to a candidate who's on the loose. That would be a waste of time. That is why I'm standing up and I'm saying, as the most popular candidate at the moment, I want to get this ticket, but I want to get it fairly.
A caucus group supporting the Jubilee Party in Kisii has since declared support for Senator Obure, accusing Maange of seeking to cause confusion in the party.
Mheshimiwa wetu ambaye ni naibu wa governor wa Kisii, ile misuko-msuko ambayo amesababisha, iyo misukosuko haistahili. Tulikuwa tumesikizana na yeye mwenyewe akachukua fursa hiyo, akatembea katika kaunti yetu yote akihamasisha wananchi ya kwamba ambaye atachukua bendera hii sio mwingine bali ni Mheshimiwa Christopher Mogere Obure. Sasa tunashangaa yeye akigeuka.
John Jacob Curia, for Channel One News.